Hi, dear students. Last video we have discussed about hidden sources. What are the merits and demerits of hidden sources? So, sources of stuffing is included two points, that is internal sources and external sources. So, we all know that internal sources is nothing but what? Whatever the stuffing activities are to be done within organization is called as the internal sources. And external sources is nothing but what? Whatever the activities relating to the stuffing is to be done outside organization is called as the external sources. So as compared to internal and external, internal sources is to be included two points, that is transfer and promotion. So employees are to be transferred from one department to another department, whether it to be promoted to the higher level of employees is called as the promotion. So next we have to study about the external sources. So external sources also having more advantages related to the staffing. Why? Because externals can get the more advantages to the staff members or staffing process, which is benefited to the organization. So let us see what are the benefits or what are the advantages or merits of external sources. So external sources is first included qualified person. So here we can say as compared to internal sources are to be existing employees have to be transferred from one department to another department. They will not get any newly qualified or new youths or new ideas is to be not implemented in the internal sources. But here we can say that external sources is one of the important advantages or is most benefited to the organization. Right? Because here we can get new employees in an organization where having the higher qualified or new youths who are more benefited to the organizations. So it is not possible in the internal sources. It is benefited from with the help of external sources. Here we can get how many departments will be there. For all departments, we get the related qualified employees in your organization. So it is one of the benefited to the organizations. With the help of qualified person only, you will get the related more helpful for the development of your organizations. When you get a qualified employee, for example, in the finance department, you needed a finance related qualified employee like a CA or a related business related commerce related employee, which is more benefited in the finance department. So overall, you can say that in the different departments, whatever the placement will be there, as related to that placement only, you get the qualified employees in your organization with the help of external sources. So next, you can say here wider choice. On the wider choice is nothing but what? Here you can get a broad options in your organization to make the selection of the new employees. So it is only possible in the external sources. Why? Because it is benefited to the overall world. Here when you make the recruitment of your organization, you will get the number of employees in your organization to make a selection. For a right job, you can make a right person. Selection is to be done with the help of external sources. It is only possible in the external sources. You can make the selection of your own choice. Who is suitable for your organization, you can be selected, which is more helpful with the help of wider choice. Here, it is one of the options. When you are going to make the selection for an organization as a staffing, it is called as the selection of the right person for a right job. So, it is one of the wider choice, which is benefited with the help of external sources for the organization. Next, fresh talent. Here we can say in internal sources, it is only having the existing partners only should be transferred or should be promoted. But here, in external sources, when you are going to make the recruitment, new recruitment yearly or when the situation should be arise in an organization, you can get the fresh talented employees. So, when you are going to make the qualified persons, when you are going to appoint the qualified persons, here you can say that fresh employees are to be appointed in your organization. When fresh members are to be take the entry in your organization, automatically your organization will be developed on the basis of new ideas, new techniques, or their new performance work is to be benefited to the organization. So it is one of the important advantages in your organization with the help of external sources. Next, you can say that competitive spirit. When you are going to make the appointment of a fresh talented employees, automatically there will be the spirit of new competitions in the world. So when you are going to make the benefited with the help of external sources, when you get the qualified employees in your organization, the qualified employees are having their own talent, own skill, own knowledge. So on that basis only you can make or you can deal with the competition world or competitive world in a business organization. So we can say as compared to the internal sources also get the more benefited to the organizations. Why? Because you will get the new ideas, innovative ideas or good performance from the employees. Automatically you can get the development of your organization. So on that basis you can say external sources includes the important four advantages, that is the you can get the qualified persons or qualified employees in your organization, and wider choice, you can get the selection of the employees in a more number, then fresh talents. So here you can say fresh employees, means new employees will get the skill, well-known skill and knowledge of the, in all the departments, and automatically when you are getting the new qualified employees, they will be having the spirit of getting into the competitive world. So on this basis you can say that external sources having the more advantages and to make the organization or get the benefits to the organizations. In next video we can start with the demerits of the external sources. Thank you.